There is a song, Moira, that the sea whispers to the land. A song for pilgrims and for babbies going to sleep.
Spirit, be with thee on every stream.
In the trough of the waves, on the crest of the billows.
You remember it, don't you, Moira?
And when Beltane brings the neap tide home, then you'll be coming back to me.
Must have climbed the hill behind the house 100 times. I know every stone. But after that hill, there's another. And then another again. And after all that, then that's the sea. And I've never been there.
What?
Yes!
Oh, oh. Woohoo!
Come to the lighthouse, Moira. Come as fast as you can.
The hill near your house is called Lan Mull, the Bald Edge. They say this is as far north as the English got before Wallace blunted their blades. Didn't hold them off for long, mind. They say Wallace escaped after the Battle of the Loch by disappearing into the ground itself. The English tried to follow and threw themselves into all manner of pits and holes. Oh.
No one's fixing this old jetty up anymore. Sit and wait. And eventually the storm blows itself out.
What?
When the dark falls over the hills, it's like a veil. You can't see your own hands or feet. You could be shrunk to the size of a mouse, or grown as large as a giant, and you wouldn't know. All my life, Uncle H has written me letters, and I wrote him letters in return. Dear Uncle H.
Now behind your house, there's the castle at Ballamuy. Called the Outer Wall, it once was powerful strong, but it's fallen to ruin now, and the king's been missing for years. They say the king ruled the outer wall for 1,000 years, but his queen, Morag, was cleverer yet. She ruled forever, and rules still. The king and the last queen of the outer wall argued until they split the kingdom in two, either side of the loch.
Blows across these peaks never stops. You can't breathe the same bit of air twice. Must have been home to a king once upon a time.
That? Up there.
Goshawk, love. It's the eyes of the queen. Cover your head. You'd know the king of the outer wall if you saw him. He's blue. Bright blue.
Oh.
The king of the outer wall kept a messenger bird on a nearby rock. Great big thing, big as a dragon it were. And when it flew, its wings blotted out the sun.
Rain stops, and the air clears.
Huh?
Love, the baby needs to sleep.
Put her on my back.
You can't carry her and all the baggage.
Put her on my back. I can have her for what little I can get, can't I? They say Achach Orl grows with fields of gold. Coins in spring, gold leaf in autumn, hard nuggets in winter.
What?
The farmers who lived in the shadow of Achach Orl were rich. They didn't farm cattle, nor malt for whiskey. They farmed pure gold, and they tilled it from the earth itself.
Whew.
Uncle Hamish has lived in the lighthouse forever, and he lives there on his own. I thought all the lighthouses were automatic now, but either they don't know about his one, or else he's never noticed the light comes on by itself. Sometimes replies would come immediately. Sometimes they'd take months to arrive. Dear Uncle H,
two casks of Spanish gold are buried on Achach Oral, brought by the French to aid Bonnie Prince Charlie. They were stolen and hidden away on the golden field.
He included a clipping with that one. By the morning, the storm has finally blown itself out. Uncle Hamish sends me letters every month or so. When I was little, he'd send me pictures, never photos. Sometimes he'd throw in a shell or a bit of a crab's leg, like he was some kind of wizard.
Oh,
Creature, Moira. And I won't dare to say a word that wasn't said to it first. You can climb down from Bala Amui, if you can find the old way.
I can't believe I'm doing this. I must be off my trolley. And an Uncle H's say so too. He's got no trolley and all. Village wants this. Farmers and kids.
Breslin Rock is the highest peak between the outer wall and the high mountains, and it knows it. And it'll make you pay for it too.
Brother taught me to climb. Kept getting himself stuck up a tree or on a roof. Not like my mam would get her fat arse up there to get him back.
Woohoo!
Once Hamish sent me a rusty nail from the Titanic. He told me he'd got it from the bottom of the sea. I was 7 years old, so like a total chump, I believed him. Night falls.
Hmm.
The tunnel seems to stretch out in front and behind. It goes on forever, like a bloody poem.
Yeah.
thing you have to ken about Uncle Hamish is that he's a total idiot. Not the annoying kind. He's the kind you talk to because you never know what he'll say next. But, you know, still an idiot.
Hush now, bairn, and I'll tell it again. Once upon a time, there was a lonely fisherman. The fisherman worked on the Loch Mullardoch, catching river trout.
Come to the sea by Beltane, he said. Something wonderful is coming. And I'm doing it. I'm coming. I must be mental. What? I suppose God at least can find this place.
The goshawk again. I don't like it. It's following us.
That's the fishing you're talking.
Maybe the Queen doesn't mind us. She's not stopping us, is she?
Yeah, that's because we're doing what she wants. She's making sure we don't turn back.
Uncle Hamish writes me letters, but he isn't chatty.
Sea's raging. Wind's up. But I can see all the way to the North Pole, I reckon.
That sort of thing.
Oh!
starting to feel like I've never done anything but walk. I can feel myself opening out. The way Uncle H says happens when you dump an oyster in a bucket of seawater.
What? Oh.
Once when I was a bairn, I put a feather on top of a peak named Gull's Perch. And it grew into a bird and flew away.
Oh, 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 oh.
The winches of the mine below Devil's Tail used to run day and night. There's no daylight in a mine, no reason to sleep. But then the English taxed the mines dry and cleared them out.
I've never seen the sea. I think my mum's afraid of it. But I've dreamt of it. And I know exactly how it sounds and how it feels.
Now the beak isn't a mountain at all. It's the great big nose of a giant asleeping on his back. Once every 500 years, he sneezes and the whole land shakes.
No snow yet, but the peaks only get colder and higher from here. The rain goes on and on until suddenly it clears.
They say the devil himself came to rest on the slopes of Erebel and Geel. But he got the spikes of his tail caught in a crack in the rock. And when he pulled himself free, he tore a hole so hot you could cook your ties over it.
Ah!
The fishermen worked on the Loch Mullardoch, catching river trout. The fisherman of Loch Mullardoch was horribly lonely. So it was the lonely fisherman took a wife, the daughter of a local farmer.
I'm the only one in my family to have green eyes. I know, who cares what colour your eyes are? Only they all have blue eyes. And there's me, with green. My little brother says I'm cursed. My little brother is a little toad. Yeah.
Every cairn is a pile of fallen soldiers. One stone placed for every man who went into battle. One stone taken back only by those who returned. In the crack where the devil lost the tip of his tail, the English found coal. Great dark seams of it. And they buried Scotsmen down there in return for the coal they took. It's an accursed place.
The rain goes on and on until suddenly it clears. My mum grew up in Inverness. I think her mum must have been Nessie herself.
Oh. Oh, oh, oh.
These hills are awash with stories. That's what happens when people are driven out. Their stories get left behind. Stray dogs, with no one to take them in.
But getting a letter was like Christmas. Dear Uncle H.
The king of the outer wall was a blue man. They live a long time, but they can't fall in love twice. His queen was Morag the First.
What? My mom left the city and moved here. I guess because she hates people. But I guess Hamish must be even worse.
Thank you. What?
My brother Ben and me should have been best mates. Some days we were, but most days I went my way and he'd sat about on his own.
Everything in this world is a balance of separated things. The sea and the shore, the hills and the valleys. The people you're with and the people you're without. And all you can do is hope for luck as you're finding the gap in between.
Fact is, I won't miss my mam. But I'll miss my brother. He might be a toad, but he's my toad. A couple of years ago, my brother Ben got ill. Went into his lungs, they said, and wouldn't he come out. That's when he moved to Edinburgh. Haven't seen him since. The rain stops and the air clears. We were going to go visit my brother in the hospital. We didn't. Then we was going to visit him at his dad's house. We didn't do that either.
So it was the lonely fisherman took a wife, the daughter of a local farmer. The farmer was a gigantic hulk of a man, and so was his massive daughter. They said the farmer's daughter could tear up trees with her bare hands, she was so strong.
Huh? Woohoo!
Is today. I won't make it on time, but I won't be too late. Maybe once I'm back from the lighthouse. Then I'll go see how little Ben's getting on.
The last slope to be cleared around here was the slope to the east of Machtala Hreicher. They say the last family to leave cried so loud, I can still hear the echo.
Woohoo!
Oh.
I like it here. Can't we stay here?
No, my love. We can't. But God be with her. In every pass.
Hamish, I can't bear it.
The hills east of Crofter's Echo. It's like things that get trapped there, don't leave, don't want to, or can't get out. I'm not sure.
Oh!
Oh, she smiled. Did you see?
How could I see that, wrapped up in there?
She smiled my smile. Not yours. You never smile.
I do. Only I do it in the dark.
My mom doesn't even look like me. I didn't fit in back home. With my mum, with my brother, I always thought, who am I? Never. What am I?
Oh.
What?
Thank you.
It's beautiful up here. I never knew the land could be so beautiful.
To see you looking at it. If I could stay here forever, I would.
I know you would. But she wouldn't.
Now, when the wind blows, I'm catching the smell of the sea. Oh, 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 oh. For my whole life, the lighthouse has marked the edge of my world. Now, I realise that's exactly what...
Huh.
Come in, Hamish. These hills are a prison, and I'm breaking out.
The darkness closes in. Dear Uncle H,
it's easier to show you than to tell you that. Come to the sea. Come and see them.
Hamish is mad, maybe? He didn't say the seals were beaching early at the lighthouse. He said it was the Selkies.
What?
Stook Butcherhin is a haunted place. They punished witches there, put them into spiked barrels, and rolled them down the hill. Some of the witches rolled into the loch and drowned. But others stuck feathers to their arms with tar. And when their barrels smashed open, they flew.
Oh.
Yikes!
Dear Uncle H.
Now a Selkie, Moira, is the most delightful creature there is. Smart as any woman, or man. But it lives in the sea. And they're old. They're always old.
Oh.
Woohoo!
What?
Great peak before the sea is the castle of Lion's Back. They say it started as a Roman fort. The Romans inside dug themselves into the ground like hobs. They were so afraid.
Once the site of plans for war, and now it's overthrown.
Here, take my arm.
I'm fine.
You're not accustomed to walking. Take my arm.
No. If I have to do this, I'm doing it myself.
The lion's back was taken on by the Jacobites. But they say, when Bonnie Prince Charlie fell, they all went mad, and they buried themselves under the castle's foundations.
Oh.
Oh.
The Jacobites were supporters of James II, the White Rose, they called him. The last hill before the sea is Ballymara, and she's the guardian of the land. She's what stops the sea itself from marching in. Though, by all accounts, she's given in mind.
Come in, Hamish.
I'm here. I made it. All the way to the sea. Hello.
Here you.
These hills are awash with stories, Moira. Let me tell you one.
Okay, that'd be nice.
Once, there was a lonely fisherman.
Did he live in a lighthouse, maybe?
Aye, he did.
I thought so.
And he was dreadful lonely. Just him and his fish. So we decided to marry his neighbour's daughter.
Oh, daddy now.
Aye, he did, but he shouldn't have, because she was a brute. Voice like thunder and arms like pitchforks she had. But her son, he was even worse.
I like this story, Hamish. Keep on with it.
Aye, and I will if you'd stop interrupting. Oh, you've got a mouth on you and no mistake.
I have. You're the one who wants to tell his stories all day. You should have your own radio programme.
Well, now, there's an idea.